Coming to the next topic is the types of cloning vectors, right? In that case, there are several types of cloning vectors are there. We know the meaning of cloning vectors, which carries our desired DNAs, and our desired DNA will be replicated or multiplicated, right? So these are called as cloning vectors. I already said there is in several types of cloning vectors are there. The very first type of vectors are plasmids. We well know about the plasmids, right? Plasmids are extra chromosomal circular double-stranded DNAs which are present in the cytoplasm of the bacteria, especially, right? Eukaryotic plasmids also there. Eukaryotic plasmids are present within the bacteria, mitochondria and chloroplast. Eukaryotic plasmids are present in mitochondria and the chloroplast. See, here we are discussing about the bacterial plasmids, right? And coming to the next one is cosmids. See, the cosmids are second type. In this case, there is an bacterial DNA is there, right? Bacteria DNA means here phase DNA, lambda phase DNA, okay, combined with the plasmid DNA. Lambda phase DNA combined with the plasmid DNA. See, whatever that lambda phase DNA is there, lambda phase DNA combined with the plasmid DNA, right? That is about the cosmid. Phase mids. We know about the phase mids. Phase mids, bacteriophages, which attacks the bacteria. So we are using the phase DNA as the vector. And next one is the TI plasmid. See, there is an Agrobacterium tumefaciensi bacteria is there. The bacteria infects the plant cells. So the bacteria contains the TI plasmid. That TI plasmid we are using as a vector, right? Cloning vector. Last one is the artificial vectors. The vectors which are designed within the laboratory. Yeast artificial vector is there. Bacterial artificial vector is there, right? We'll discuss about one by one, right? The very first one is the plasmids. Okay, we know extra chromosomal circular double-stranded DNA which are present in the cytoplasm of the bacteria, right? And see, this is one of the plasmid. This plasmid inserted into the E. coli cell. Sir, prokaryotic plasmids are expressed in eukaryotic cells. The prokaryotic plasmids are not expressed in eukaryotic cells. Sir, eukaryotic plasmids are expressed in prokaryotic cells or not? Eukaryotic plasmids are not expressed in prokaryotic cells. Means, eukaryotic plasmids are expressed in eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic plasmids are expressed in prokaryotic cells. Right? Because whatever that the sequences are there, we know about the promoter sequences. Prokaryotic promoters are there. Eukaryotic promoters are there. The promoter sequences are very very specific to interact with the enzymes. So RNA polymerase enzymes recognizes the promoter sequences. So that's the reason why prokaryotic genes expressed in prokaryotic cells. Eukaryotic genes expressed in eukaryotic cells. So prokaryotic cloning vectors are expressed in prokaryotic cells. Eukaryotic cloning vectors are expressed in eukaryotic cells. Right, so here this is one of the plasmid. Okay, the plasmid, that is nothing but structure of PBR322. We already discussed. This is one of the artificial vector. Okay, this vector inserted into the E. coli cell. The vector contains the different types of sites are there. Okay, we'll discuss one by one. Here the very first one is the origin of replication site. This one is also called Oryzae site. This is the one of the plasmid. The plasmid contains the Oryzae site. The Oryzae site is very important. The Oryzae site is very important for the plasmid replication process. The Oryzae site is very important for the plasmid replication process. The Oryzae site involved in the initiation of plasmid replication. We know about the DNA replication. In that, there is an initiation of DNA replication. Here DNA replication is nothing but initiation of plasmid replication. Initiation of plasmid replication done by the oryzocyte. Initiation of plasmid replication done by the oryzocyte. In the last class, we discussed about if the oryzocyte is strongly attract the DNA polymerase enzymes, okay, more number of plasmids are produced. If the oryzocyte weakly attracts the DNA polymerase enzyme, less number of plasmids are produced. Always in biotechnology process, the oryzocyte is very strong to attract the DNA polymerase enzymes and more number of plasmids are produced. More number of plasmids are produced because these plasmids are artificially synthesized or artificially designed plasmids. That's the reason why, okay, we can expect in this case the best. We can expect in this case the best because these are designed in laboratory. These are designed in laboratory, right? That is about the oryzocyte. And coming to the next one is, oryzocyte function is initiation of the plasmid DNA replication or plasmid replication, right? Selectable markers. See, within that TBR322, okay, two selectable markers are there. One of the ampicillin resistant gene, other one is the tetracycline resistant gene. Ampicillin resistant gene, tetracycline resistant gene. In first year, we discussed about one of the concept. This is the bacteria. The bacteria having R plasmid. The bacteria having R plasmids, right? Presence of R plasmids, the bacteria, okay, the particular bacteria can survive presence of antibiotics. Presence of antibiotics. So, sir, how the bacteria have the capacity to survive presence of antibiotics? See, the bacteria contains plasmids. The plasmids contains antibiotic resistant genes. That antibiotic resistant gene, okay, this is one of the antibiotic resistant gene, produces mRNA. That mRNA produces enzymes. These enzymes are involved in the destruction of antibiotics. These enzymes are involved in the destruction of antibiotics, right? So, see what we are tagging, okay, these are called as selectable markers. The selectable markers are nothing but antibiotic resistant genes. The selectable markers in PBR322 is nothing but antibiotic resistant genes. Antibiotic resistant genes. See, ampicillin resistant gene, R indicates here resistant. Tetracycline resistant gene, right? Not only these two, chlorofenicol resistant gene, kanamycin resistant gene, right? So, different types of antibiotic resistant genes are tagged to the plasmid. So, these are called as selectable markers. These are called as selectable markers, right? Selectable markers are involved in the identification of transformants. Transformants are nothing but simple. This is one of the bacteria cell, natural bacteria cell. It contains the plasmid. And this is the another bacteria cell, right? It contains the plasmid with our desired genes. Plasmid with our desired genes. Okay. Both are cultivated. Both are cultivated. See, we need to isolate our desired cells. We need to isolate our desired cells. These are also called transformants. Okay. These cells are also called transformants. These cells are called as non-transformants. These are called as non-transformants. These are called as transformants. See, the concept is, okay, for biotechnology purpose, after insertion of desired DNA into the plasmid, if the recombinant plasmid inserted into the one of the bacteria, we need to isolate this particular bacteria cell. This particular bacteria cell. Or we need to identify this particular bacteria cell. So for that purpose, okay, we already inserted selectable markers. Selectable markers. Ampicillin resistant gene and tetracycline resistant gene. Ampicillin resistant gene and the tetracycline resistant gene. So this is the natural bacteria, natural plasmid. Maybe, okay, majority of the E. coli plasmids, not contains the antibiotic resistant gene. Mostly natural E. coli bacteria, natural E. coli plasmid not contains the antibiotic resistant gene. Both are cultivated in, both these bacteria are cultivated in antibiotic contained media. So both these bacteria are cultivated in antibiotic content media, the natural bacteria will be dead. The natural bacteria will be dead. But whatever that transformed cells are there, these cells are not dead because the plasmid contains the antibiotic restraint gene. The plasmids contains the antibiotic restraint gene. So this is nothing but selection of transformants. Selection of transformants. See, these are the non-transformants. These are the transformants. We are selecting the transformant cells. We are selecting the transformant cells by the usage of selectable markers. By the usage of selectable markers. Right? That is about the ampicillin and the tetracycline. Not only these two, there is in chlorpenicol is there. And kanamycin is also there. Okay, several types of antibiotic resistant genes are there. That is about the selectable markers. And next one is the cloning sites. Where we are inserting the desired DNA, the particular site is called as cloning site. Okay, within the plasmid, we are inserting our desired DNA at particular location. So the site is called as cloning site. Generally, majority of the cases, this site is called as cloning site. Majority of the cases, this site is called as cloning site. But in certain cases, other than this site also, okay, scientists are inserting the desired DNA. Scientists are inserting the desired DNA. Majority of the cases in this location, okay, inserting the desired DNA. Okay, so how the insertion is takes place? We know by the cutting of plasmid DNA. How the cutting is carried out here. So we are using different types of restriction endonuclease enzymes. ECO-R1. Cuts at the cloning site. CLA-1 cuts at the cloning site. HIND-3 cuts at the cloning site. So once any one enzyme if we use, right, the DNA is cut, okay, one of the desired DNA is tagged by the DNA ligase enzyme or alkaline phosphatase enzyme, right? That is about the normal cloning site. Okay, in certain cases, other than that site also, okay, we are inserting the desired DNA. See, this is the ampicillin restraint gene. Ampicillin restraint gene cutted by PVU1 or PST1. PVU1 or PST1 using to cut the ampicillin restraint gene. So, in this place also, in this place or within ampicillin restraint gene also, we can insert our desired gene. We can insert our desired gene. And next one. Tetracycline restraint gene. BAMH1 is the enzyme. Okay, SAL1 is the enzyme. By the usage of BAMH1 or by the usage of SAL1, okay, we can cut the tetracycline restraint gene, right? We can insert our desired gene. So mostly here, right? We can insert our desired gene, right? That is about that cloning site. See, here rope site is mostly used, mostly not used. Rope site is mostly not used for the insertion. I will explain. See, last one is the rope site. Here rope site is nothing but, okay, some of the proteins which are involved in the replication. So, synthesis of proteins which are involved in replication. Rope site indicates synthesis of proteins which are involved in replication. So that particular bit, involved in the synthesis of enzymes. These enzymes are involved in the replication process. See, enzymes are nothing but proteins. Synthesis of proteins which are involved in replication, right? So this site is also cutted by PVU2. So for the insertion of our desired DNA, ORI-C site is not cutted. ORI-C site is lost. There is no DNA replication process. So ORI-C site is not cutted for the insertion of our desired DNA. Mostly, yeah, rope site is also not cutted because that bit is supporting for the synthesis of enzymes which are involved in DNA replication process, right? That is about the rope site. And next one, the plasmid mustard should be have the small size. So why the plasmid needs small size? Why the vector should be small size? Okay, if the plasmid size is small, okay, that plasmids are easily penetrated into host cell. If the plasmid size is large, during penetration process or during insertion process, maybe the plasmids are broken down. So if the plasmid size is small, which are easily inserted into host cell, right? That is about the size of the plasmid. And next one is the low molecular weight. See, the size is small means here low molecular weight. Low molecular weight is there, easily penetrated. Right? So here the small size and low molecular weight, these two are related to the insertion of plasmids into host cells, right? That is about the plasmids. And next one we'll discuss about the cosmids. Coming to the next one is the cosmids. Cosmids means here one of the lambda phase DNA. These two are combinedly called as cosmids. And these plasmids, plasmids means the combination structures are having cosites. Here, cosites are nothing but cohesive ends. So, cosmids means lambda phase DNA. Okay, see anybody want to write here lambda phase DNA, right? Next one, lambda phase DNA combined with the plasmid. See, this is one of the combination structure. That combination structure having cosites. The cosites, are nothing but cohesive ends. So within that cohesive ends, our desired genes are inserted. Okay, where that cohesive ends are there, that place cutted, in that place our desired genes are inserted. That is about the cosmids. And next is the phasmids. Phasmids are nothing but bacteriophages. This is one of the bacteriophages, right? Naturally, it has the capacity to infect the bacteria cells. Okay, the bacteriophage contains the genetic material. In that, whatever that bacteriophage contains, original genetic material is there at particular location. Okay, the bacteria genes are deleted. This is the bacteriophage genetic material. In that place, our desired genes are added. Again, these genes are reinserted into the bacteria. So this is one of the viral genetic material. Then these bacteriophages infect the bacteria. Our desired genes are transferred, right? That is about the phase DNA. Remember here phages which are attacks the bacteria. Coming to the next one is the TI plasmids. TI plasmids means tumor inducing plasmids. See, this is the one of the plant. Maybe this is one of the groundnut plant, right? Within that groundnut plant, there is a stem part is there. This is the stem part. and leaves are also there. Branches are there and leaves are there. Right? This is the root part, right? See, some of the bacteria. So, this is one of the groundnut plant. See, some of the bacteria like Agrobacterium, tumefaciens. So, Agrobacterium tumefaciens is the bacteria. That bacteria contains the TI plasmid. So, this is the bacteria. The bacteria contains the TA plasmid. Okay. See, the bacteria infects the plant stems. Agrobacterium tumefaciens bacteria infects the stems and leaves. Causes the cancer in plants. Cancer in plants means uncontrolled cell division. So, Agrobacterium tumefaciens bacteria, the bacteria contains the TI plasmid. This is the TI plasmid. That TI plasmid contains bacteria, infects the stems. Okay, and it causes the cancer. This disease is called as crown gall disease. It's like cancer. So uneven cell division takes place. So there is an abnormal structures are produced due to the uncontrolled cell division. So how this plasmid? How this plasmid have the capacity to cause uncontrolled cell division? See, whatever that TA plasmid contains genes are there, the genes are responsible for the production of cytokinins, phytohormone, and the auxins. Majorly cytokines, because the plant cell division controlled by the cytokines. Cyto means cell, kinins, which are involved in the cell division, right? So cytokines are produced by the plasmid contain a bit of DNA. Presence of these cytokines and auxins, okay, the plant cells shows the uncontrolled cell division. Uncontrolled cell division is nothing but crown gall disease. Uncontrolled cell division is nothing but the crown gall disease. Sir, why we are discussing here? See, within biotechnology, the TI plasmid we are using as vector. Sir, how? Whatever that cytokinin and auxin producing genes are there, the genes are deleted. In that place, our desired genes are added. Once our desired genes are added, this is one of the modified bacteria. The modified Agrobacterium tumefaciens bacteria infects the plant cells. And transfers the our desired genes into plant cells. Right? So that is about the TI plasmid, tumor-inducing plasmids. Because which are having auxins and cytokines producing genes. So presence of that genes, the bacteria influences the plant cell division process. Right? The disease is nothing but crown gall disease. So whatever that Agrobacterium tumefaciens contains, TI plasmid is there, the cytokines and auxins producing genes, we are deleted. In that place, our desired genes are added. So our desired genes are transferred into the plant cells. Then our desired genes are expressed in plant cells. Our desired product will be produced. That is about the TA plasmids. Last one, artificial vectors. Simple, yak and back. Artificial vectors, in that case the very first one is the bacterial artificial chromosome. Bacterial artificial chromosome, yak, yeast artificial chromosome. Both these are artificial chromosomes which carries the maximum number of our desired genes. Maximum number of our desired genes. One is the bacterial artificial chromosome. Bacterial artificial chromosome. Right here, yeast artificial, yeast artificial chromosome. Right. So the bacterial artificial chromosome expressed in prokaryotic cells. Yeast artificial chromosome expressed in eukaryotic cells. This one is expressed in eukaryotic cells. This one is expressed in prokaryotic cells. Right. That is about some of the cloning vectors. Some of the cloning vectors, right? These are the vectors which carries our desired genes. See the capacity of different types of vectors. The capacity of different types of vectors. Which one carries very minimum number of our desired genes? Which one carries the maximum number of our desired genes? Remember, see the vector, the first one is the plasmid. Here KB indicates 1 KB is equals to 1000 nucleotides or 1000 base pairs, right? See, here the plasmid, here kilo base pairs, capacity indicated here kilo base pairs, 0.5 to 8 kilo base pairs. Bacteriophage capacity is the 9 to 23 kilo base pairs. Cosmid, okay, the third one is the cosmid, 30 to 45 kilo base pairs. Back. See, these two are artificial, okay, all these are artificial, but back and ac, which are specially designed to carry the desired genes, back, okay, bacterial artificial chromosome, 50 to 300, ac, okay, in that case, 1000 to 2500. Now, all these, okay, the maximum capacity exhibited by the ac, the maximum capacity exhibited by the ac, remember, sometimes wit is given one of the best carrier or best vector to carry our desired genes in the given options. Okay, based on that options we have to choose. For suppose ac is given, we have to choose the ac. Ac is not given. These four are given. In that case we have to choose the back. Okay. Maybe other are given. Okay, based on that we have to choose. So the very minimum plasmid, maximum is the ac, and these are bacteriophage. Okay, below that, yeah, more than plasmid. Bacteriophage is more. Yeah, this is the plasmid, right? First one, very minimum. Next one is the bacteriophage. Next one is the cosmid. Next one is the bac. Okay, the highest one is the ac. That is about the carrying capacities of different types of cloning vectors. The very best one is the ac. The very best vector to carry the maximum number of our desired genes is the YAC, right? And remember, see, within that laboratory, some of the vectors are designed. These are very special vectors. These are called shuttle vectors. Shuttle vectors. Sometimes this one also given. Okay, last AAP and exams, AIMS, again that exams also given. Shuttle vector. What is shuttle vector? Generally, I said one statement is given. Vectors, some are only expressed in eukaryotic cells. Some are only expressed in prokaryotic cells. Okay. But some of the vectors which are designed in laboratory, some of the vectors which are designed in laboratory, okay, which are expressed in both prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells, which are expressed in both prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Okay, whatever the vectors which are expressed in both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, these vectors are called as shuttle vectors. These vectors are called as shuttle vectors, right? That is about the shuttle vectors and the carrying capacity of the different types of vectors.